pick, put it down in the comments below as we will also give our predictions shortly with you starting. Let's go, Gani. Which draft you like better?
I gotta be honest with you guys. I like Orenzio on this glue. I gotta pick with Execration.
Execration won. Now, Momo, give me your thoughts on the drafts. Which
one
do you like?
I really like the composition coming from Execration here.
Whoa!
With a combo from Claude and also Veil. So I will go for Execration for the game number one.
2-0 Execration. And for me, I will actually pick EVO's Legends for this one. I think they have a solid draft in the early game. They have that Bakito to carry them through that early game, get some damage onto that Veil, and in the late game, they also have some insurance. But let's stop talking. Let's stop predicting. Ladies and gentlemen, the final match of the day. Let's get it. Execration versus EVO's Legends here in the upper brackets.
Yep, Chaknu with his Matilda. Meanwhile, Kalura will stay in the top lane here with his Lunox. Meanwhile, Persic is going to, you know, maybe try to sell a lot of items, trying to make a lot of space as well. Meanwhile, LJ plays so aggressive.
Yeah, already zoning kill VJ away from his own purple buff as he is forced to go to that orange buff right now. LJ with this Bakito, we've seen even Leo Murphy play this kind of style with that Bakito. Just go inside to the enemy jungle, disturb the enemy jungle, like we see with the Jawhead and also with the two support meta.
Yep.
Momo-chan.
E2 max. This is what makes Execration look so strong though. They have the early composition from this Matilda and also this Veil.
Yeah, now already LJ pressuring E2 Max, trying to pressure Kill VJ as well, but unfortunately Kill VJ will be able to secure that orange buff with the help of Retribution, and now Chaknu zoning EVOS away. EVOS has to be careful here because in the early game, Veil does so much damage if they just do not respect the damage, do not respect the utilities from this Veil. Not only does he do damage, but also a knock-up ability from the side of Execration.
Actually, it depends on the how E2max will play this Veil, because if he can choose between it's gonna be a lot of damage coming from this Veil, or maybe it's gonna be another CC that will help his teammate for the teamfight.
Yeah, already a lot of damage, but right now, give me your thoughts onto this game, Gani. Tell me what's happening, tell me what the teams are strategizing.
I think personally here, LJ, play smartly here. He wants to give pressure, but of course he does not want to be offside or overcommit things that isn't well calculated, but I see both junglers farmed up well.
Oh, stun up coming in from Persic, zoning Renzio away. Has to use the Torn Apart Memory actually to zone him away, as Chaknu will be able to chunk a little bit of EVO's anti-mage's health right there. But again, guys, this is a very, very intense matchup. Both teams are respecting each other so much right now, as they do not force onto any of the objectives. They do not force any team fights right now, playing it very, very slow. Chaknu now dealing damage onto Rexy, but Persic will be able to pick up that gold buff and the lead as well. Now, look at that, LJ in the backside gonna be able to go onto Persic. No, not first. Chaknu. Chaknu is gonna get taken down. First blood by EVOS. Anti-Mage gets a kill on to kill VJ. And this is not what Execration wants to do. Brody now trying to get a kill.
Renzio?
The healing comes in. Renzio trying to run away, but look at the damage coming in. Look at the utility coming in. It will be E2max trying to save him as Anti-Mage joins back in. That is two kills picked up by EVOS Legends.
Oh my god. Execration, they lose three members just now with the team fight that happening in with EVOS Legend in the river.
Wow, that's not
looking really good for Execration.
Yeah, I think for now Execration needs to hold off team fight. They do not they want to play passive. I mean, with Claude, they want to enter the late game as farmed up as
and look at this, Anti-Mage doing Anti-Mage things right now as he goes in onto two members. Renzio will be able to brook him back, but Anti-Mage goes back in. He actually goes on to kill VJ. A kill picked up by EVOS, and now they're going onto Renzio. Anti-Mage will be traded back. E2max will get a kill. They're looking for more. Percy comes in with a stun. He's gonna use the Torn Apart Memory to finish Chaknu off, and that is a 2-for-1 trade.
Wow, EVOS Legion, now they are looking really dominant in the early game with the good follow that always coming from this team.
Very, very good follow-up right there. Gani, any thoughts?
Yeah, I think, like I said, Execration needs to hold off fights, guys. I mean, EVOS, they're willing to take fights right here, right now, but Claude is not farmed up.
Yeah, the stun comes in, and Gani, Renzio is a goner. It's going to be Persic picking up another kill on the board. 2-0.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well, then again, here, we can see EVOS Legends really, really taking the control of the map.
Top side though, and now Anti-Mage goes for a kill onto E2. Max Clover will be traded back though as Kelra. No, Chaknu gets the kill there in the top side. Now Anti-Mage rotating to that top side, trying to cover for his fallen brother. But Pharisaic is also trading that bottom side. He will be able to get that turret right now, and Anti-Mage will be able to defend the top side, Gani.
Yeah, exactly. But Claude here needs to farm like Genius's space, and gets his item, and basically then, and not until then, Execration could win a team fight, basically.
Yeah, and Execration already playing towards this top side, knowing that this Herith isn't as strong as Kelra, as Lunox right now. So Anti-Mage has to rotate, but they're switching sides on the map. They're changing their priorities on the map, as EVO's Legends are completely controlling the bot side, but Execration are completely controlling the top side.
You're absolutely right, guys, and right now, we can see
but look at that, Summon Force being used, now popping onto E2 Max. The Circling Eagle connects onto Clover, but there is still healing right there as LJ follows it up all the way to the back side. Now Chaknu gets taken very low, but there will be no kills on the board for both teams. A lot of resources spent by EVO's Legends trying to make that play, though. So Execration, they still have a lead in terms of abilities as of this moment, Gani.
Exactly, more control of EVO's, more objectives. One turret and an extra turtle here for EVO's Legends. Meanwhile, Execration, they are still struggling because they lost control of the map right now, but then again, we will see towards the late game here, Execration still have a chance.
Yeah, the Pharisaic already one level ahead right now as he just chunks towards this turret. He will actually zone two members away from his turret. Clover will be able to secure that bottom side turret, and now EVO is playing the long game, playing just for the rotations, for the pressure on the lane as well.
Yes, and all the zoning strategy that EVO's Legion doing right now works really perfectly for them.
Yeah,
look at that Anti-Mage. And LJ, he just keeps giving a lot of damage as well.
That is so much damage.
That Kilra.
You're right, but Kill VJ, remember guys, he has been farming up a notch here. He has been scaling after the second death. He has been focused on farming. So right now, still a level. They're still on the same level. And from the items, Gani, tell me what you can see.
Exactly. Claude is still trying to build up on that VHS. Meanwhile, Brody, is already heading towards that BOD right here.
Yeah, and again, EVO's Legends just trying to get objectives on the board, trying to clear the waves as fast as possible. And for the side of Execration, they are more reacting than making the proactive moves. As Clover now joins in the fight, he actually goes in to zone the enemy team, and they will be able to get a turret now.
Because
of the order being used on that Kelra right now, as Pharisaic will not be able to deal some damage, but Chaknu is a target. LJ trying to zone them away, and that was beautiful from the side of EVO's Legends, just taking turrets one by one, zoning them away, and no turrets have fallen from the side of EVO's just yet.
Yep, 4k the gold difference is in the hand of EVO's Legion Execration. Now they are trying to find a momentum actually how to come back. They cannot, maybe they can give a lot of time as well for KLVJ to just keep snowballing or maybe trying to, you know.
Oh, but the Torn Apart Memory comes in and LJ goes in for the flank. He'll be able to get one kill. That's a killing spree picked up by Pharisaic. They're going in, but look at the Veil. He's trying to do damage, but it won't be enough as EVO's Legends will just be able to walk out of that one. Going on to Kelra, forcing him to use the Brilliance of the Order. Once again, EVO's are controlling the space of the game as they push every single lane. Anti-Mage goes in with the Bravest Fighter to the backside. Gonna be able to get an E2 max stunned up. Now,
Clover
uses the Mount Force to the backside as well. Gonna be able to almost get him taken down. The stun comes in to kill VJ. He's taken very low. Chaknu goes in for the Circling Eagle, and this is the combination from Kelra. The shutdown picked up by Pharisaic. No, the shutdown picked up by Kelra. A double kill, and EVO's Legends are forced to retreat away.
Yep, we've seen the good Circling Eagle actually being popped up by Chaknu just now. Pharisaic is the only target that Execration wants, though.
Exactly, they made the winning condition right there, taking down first.
But Chaknu, look at that Anti-Mage on, even though the Zaman Force being popped up as well by Clover here, but still to take
actually,
as well
from Anti-Mage flickered in, almost getting a kill onto E2 Max, and now they go onto Renzio, but there is a lot of damage here. Anti-Mage has to be careful, still trying to run away, but the damage is still there. Anti-Mage will be taken down, a killing spree taken. Rexy gets taken down as well, a double kill, and this is looking bad for EVO's Legends. Execration getting two kills for nothing, going for the third turtle.
Yep, Pharisaic has to be careful with his positioning here.
Exactly, and take a look at the gold, guys. Only 1,000 lead right now for EVO's Legends. They need to be careful. EVO's Legends, they are rushing things, you know? They need to be more disciplined in the next few minutes. And Execration, they will take advantage in EVO's Legends' mistake.
After got 4 points by Kelra, he's now become the the reaches, I can say.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. A lot of shutdowns.
Two doubles down.
Clover joins in. Zaman Force has been popped, trying to go in, but it will be the Valor Image saving him to get away. Clover actually gets hit by the knockout. Now KillVJ goes in as well.
Oh, Rexy?
It will be the blaze to win. Rexy takes a very low.
KillVJ?
And Clover trying to run away. It will be Rexy taken down, but Anti-Mage will look for a pick off as well. Anti-Mage now goes in for more, but it is only going to be 1-for-1 as LJ will be taken down as well. 2-for-1 for side of Execration. It is a disaster. They keep on going. KillVJ gets Clover. Freshick trying to make something, but 4-for-1. Evos are looking bad.
No, yes. Execration, they already found their momentum to turn back the table. They are looking to finish the game as soon as possible, or maybe they just want to straight away took all of the inhibitors right immediately.
Freshick gets bursted down. It is Evos Legends in the death penalty right now. LJ trying to save the game. Execration trying to finish it, rushing things perhaps. And Evos will still be able to secure that defense. But my goodness, what a throw by Evos.
What a really good comeback coming from Execration. Now, they just need to wait for the perfect momentum to get the first Lord in the 32nd.
You're right, and now Evos. Wow, Gani, give me some thoughts right here.
Execration doing, they know the conditions, all right? They know they are strong in the team fights right now as they already got the items and probably winning positions. And Evos, they lost their momentum right here.
Look at the moment Kalra comes.
Exactly. The moment Kalra comes, it's just over, as this is the replay brought to you by Oppo, Gani.
Exactly. There were no spells, unfortunately, for Evos, so they just have to take the damage, and it was... they could not withstand it.
Yeah,
and the
first-point
eagle again and again from Chaknu is just so good.
It is a 2,000 gold lead, almost a 3,000 gold lead for Execration as of this moment in the 10th minute mark. And this is not good, considering that Execration, they have a more late game style of composition with Kelra and KillVJ.
Exactly. But take a look at the item, guys. I mean, Brody immediately making Athena shield, guys, because of the damage, because they were behind there. He realizes that he needs defense.
Yeah, even Legion didn't realize that this Lunox could be a disaster for them, and they haven't found an answer how to shut down Kelra with this Lunox, because they cannot reach into the backline. It's not easy for Evos Legion since Ethel Execration, they have Ethel Max.
Oh, but look at this, already split up. Evos Legends are split up. Clover will be hit by the circling eagle.
Oh,
as they are
going to
look for a
spot.
It's going to be bursting around. Now, Ferrisic trying to make the most of the situation. Rexy trying to do something. Anti-Mage will be taken down. It is Execration just pushing everything. Ferrisic trying to do something. Will be able to get one kill.
But Clover
gets taken down as well. It is Execration taking the team fight.
No,
Evos, Ferrisic, the last man standing. A triple kill for Kelra.
And even a one-out for Execration. Now they are looking to finish and take the game number one without anything that Evos Legion can do.
My Execration.
What a good comeback.
They know the condition, guys. They know the condition. They know they have a strong lineup entering mid-game. They just basically okay.